Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Komal Kavalshikhavit, and in this video, I'm going to discuss the topic heteroscedasticity. So let's start with it. As you can see, I have already imported the data file in eViews. The time period is from 2000 to 2019, and there are total 20 observations in my data set. These are all the dependent and independent variables. Okay, so first of all, let's understand what is heteroscedasticity. So in the entire video, I will be discussing step by step what is heteroscedasticity, why heteroscedasticity is a problem, how we can detect heteroscedasticity in our model, and how to remove heteroscedasticity from our regression model. Okay, so let's start with it. So first of all, the question is, what is heteroscedasticity? See, it refers to a data generating process in which the disturbances terms which are drawn from an underlying population have different variances. Okay, so if the variances are same, then it is referred as homoscedasticity. But if the variances are different, which are drawn from a population, then in that case it refers to heteroscedasticity. Visually, we can judge whether a data set have a heteroscedasticity or not by looking at the distribution of y values around the estimated regression line. So as you can see in these two figures, the first one shows homoscedasticity because the data or the distribution of y values around the estimated regression line is less scattered. Whereas in the second figure, the diagram refers to heteroscedasticity because the data of or the values of y are scattered. Okay. Now, why heteroscedasticity is a problem? See, in the presence of heteroscedasticity, the OLS estimators are linear and unbiased, but they are not efficient. It means they have not minimum variance. Okay, it means that they does not satisfy the blue property, that is best linear unbiased estimators. So this is because the variance of the error term and variance of OLS estimators are biased. Okay. As a result, the confidence intervals in hypothesis testing is not reliable in case when the OLS estimators are not satisfying the property of minimum variance. And hence, the test statistics which are usually followed, that is T statistics and F statistics, they do not show reliable results. And hence, in case of heteroscedasticity, instead of ordinary least square methods, other methods, that is generalized least square GLS and weighted least square WLS methods are used. Now, the question is how to detect heteroscedasticity. In literature, there are various methods like Parks test, Glejser test, White's test, and Breusch Pagan Goldfrey test, which is widely used. So in case of heteroscedasticity, the null hypothesis states that there is no heteroscedasticity in the model, or the model is homoscedastic. And the alternative hypothesis is that there is a presence of heteroscedasticity in the model. Now, we conclude the results by following the thumb rule, which is if the p-value is less than 5% level of significance, that is, if the probability value is less than 0.05, then we reject H0, that is, we are rejecting that there is no heteroscedasticity. It means there is a presence of heteroscedasticity in the model. Now, finally, after detecting heteroscedasticity, how we can remove this? So, for removing heteroscedasticity, you can use any of these methods. So, one of the methods is Either we can do model respecification or do some data transformation. Data transformation in the sense that you can convert your regression model in logarithmic format. The other method is using weighted least squared methods, WLS methods. It is also widely used in case of heteroscedasticity. In case of WLS methods, you can change your variables. Okay, you can attach some weight to the variables. For instance, let's take a hypothetical example. Suppose in your data set, there is an independent variable GD, okay, and there is heteroscedasticity in the model. In that case, to remove this, what you can do, instead of GDP, you can use per capita GDP in your model, okay? So you have attached some weights and you are calculating or running the regression model in per capita terms. Finally, you can use heteroscedasticity consistent standard errors. So this is basically the heteroscedasticity autocorrelation consistent test, which is known as HAC test. So we can use HAC test to remove heteroscedasticity. So let's start with it. So first of all, in EUs, we need to run a normal regression, simple regression. So first select your dependent variable followed by all the independent variables and open these as equation. Okay, so this is the regression model. Now click OK. As you can see, the results for simple regression model are obtained. Now, to detect whether there is a presence of heteroscedasticity or not, go to View, then Residual Diagnostic and select Heteroscedasticity Test. The probability chi-square value is 0.0809, which is greater than 5% level of significance. In that case, we accept our null hypothesis, that is, there is no heteroscedasticity in the model. However, I will show you how we can remove heteroscedasticity if this probability value is less than 5%. Suppose if you have encountered with the problem of heteroscedasticity in your regression model, then in that case, run the regression again, and now you can transform your regression model by taking log of all the variables. So you have transformed your regression model. So first select your dependent variable followed by all the independent variables and open this as equation. Now this was the simple regression model. So now we can run the regression model by taking log of all these variables. Okay, I have transformed my regression model in logarithmic format. Now you can run the regression. So these are the results for the regression model. You can see the variables are now in log format. Now to detect whether there is a presence of heteroscedasticity or not, go to View, Residual Diagnostics and select Heteroscedasticity Test. Select Breusch Pagan Godfrey Test and click OK. Now here you can see the results for chi-square probability. The probability value is 0.147, which is greater than 5% level of significance, and it is also greater than 10% level of significance. It means that we accept null hypothesis, that is, there is no heteroscedasticity in the model. So in this way, you can remove heteroscedasticity by transforming your model. The other method is HAC test. So to run HAC test, go to Estimate, click on Options here, and in the covariance method, select HAC test, okay, and click OK. So test basically corrects the standard errors by adjusting the t values and p values. So the regression results obtained by running the HAC test are already free from heteroscedasticity. Okay, so while reporting the results, you can mention the regression coefficients obtained by estimating the head test. So in that manner, you can solve the heteroscedasticity problem if there is any in your regression model. Thanks for watching. I hope you like the video.